Hi everyone, so I wanted to come back this week. I was super, super excited that HomeGoods is finally open again in my area, so I just had to jump in there and start looking for things that I had on my list since everything started. One of my favorite things about HomeGoods is they carry so many different things, from just different seasonings. I am a huge cook in the kitchen. I love just creating recipes, doing recipes, or just having fun in the kitchen, and I just love that they offer just different spices, as you can see, for really great prices that would probably be double in a specialty store. Pastas, coffees, and just different snacks, coffees, things like that. I was definitely in the market for some new bowls and just other things for the kitchen, and I just love that they just have all of these different prints, and they're beautiful. They're amazing. I just love how nice they look, and just the prices, you cannot beat it. So there's not always a huge selection if you're trying to, like, just, you know, have a whole collection, but if you just want a couple of different pieces, I mean, a beautiful plate like this can always be repurposed for just, you know, dessert trays, you know, cake plates, things like that. So my big thing is every time I go into HomeGoods, I try to think outside the box, and I want you guys to do the same. You know, if you see a basket, how can you repurpose it? It doesn't always have to just be a basket. It can be turned into a lamp. It could be turned into something that you use in the kitchen. It could be used to just house different tools in the garage, but just give it a more uniform look. So that was what I was on the hunt for. I needed something for the backyard to actually put the hose in. And of course, yeah, it's a little bit different than the traditional, you know, box or something that you can get from HomeGoods, or sorry, from Home Depot. But I just figure, you know, Home Depot is my husband's mall, HomeGoods is mine. So I was, you know, also looking for some different quilting for my bed. I was on the hunt for a couple of weeks for just something really nice and clean looking in a almost silver shade like this quilt, and I was so bummed that it was in a queen and I couldn't find a king in the same color. So, but for $59, that's not bad for a whole set. So if that's something that you're looking for, I know they always have queen sizes available and things like that. So but just even just the bed sheets, I find that the quality for the sheets is really nice at really great prices. But it's not too overwhelming, like if you go into a home, you know, like Macy's or any other home store. So just, I love the rugs and everything else. It just always has beautiful things. That's been something that I've been, you know, really going after since, you know, all of this quarantine and things like that started, is I have so many photos on my phone and I need to get them into frames. So that's what I was also on the hunt for, but I was still on the hunt for a basket, and I'm just trying to figure out, okay, what can I do? What could I use? And just trying to figure out, like, you know, the great prices, but just what could I use that would be a little bit different for the backyard? Another one of my favorite things to purchase there are their lotions and soaps. They have, like, really great sprays for the bedroom, just different oils, and not a lot of cosmetics, which is nice. That's not what I go there for, but just, you know, a lot of the body washes and linen sprays, just different things like that. I definitely ended up picking up this one. I just loved the design of the outside of the bottle and also the price. It was not bad, so I just thought, yep, I'm definitely gonna take this one. And I just loved, like, the design and the detail of it. Yeah, it was great. And I was like, oh, kind of matches my shoe too, not bad. But yeah, so I definitely, that went definitely into the basket. That was a for sure find. I needed some new soaps, but I just like finding really pretty bottles that if I just do regular refills, I could still keep, you know, the soap bottle itself as, you know, a decoration, just to kind of keep by this, you know, the sink all the time. and just a lot of those sprays. Some of them were a little too fruity for me. I know my husband would not like that. But just little things like this to keep in the bathroom. I mean, it just looks like you spent so much more than $7.99. And especially living in Oregon where there's no sales tax, I love the fact that whatever the price is, the price is. And then recently, I've just been kind of doing my own art. I have another video coming with some, you know, resin art that I did recently. And I took inspiration from a lot of these. And these do also remind me of that Z Gallery look where they put a lot of glitter into their paintings and things like that for showcase. And I just love that I was able to kind of get what I wanted from the piece that I did myself, but I just love getting inspiration from here. So if that's something that you guys wanted to see, I did like another, you know, just a little small remodel in my living room upstairs, and that video will be coming soon. So I have this whole nautical thing going in my backyard, and I found this piece. I thought it was so cute. It just has like the starfish on it. Another one had like sand dollars, but I thought with the color and everything else, that it was just so beautiful. I definitely wanted to go with it. So I stumbled upon this and I was trying to think, how can I make this look a little bit more nautical? And if this is something you have, you can always go to Home Depot and purchase their rope by the yard and then just kind of intertwine it through. And then I stumbled upon this. It was in the kids section and I'm sure it's for toys, but I love thinking outside the box and thinking, how can I repurpose this in the way that I want? And it can still be a little bit fun and funky at the same time. So stay tuned for that because I found a great idea for it.
Well, thank you so much for joining me. I'm so excited that HomeGoods is finally open. I could not contain myself enough to film everything that I wanted to, but I'm very excited to take home all of the things that I found and to kind of show you how I put them together. I like finding things that are a little bit off the beaten path or a little bit different than I think a lot of people would probably use them for, or just repurposing them in general. So I'm excited to kind of just see how everything turns out, and I'll kind of show you guys where I place them in the house, and you can kind of see just the madness come to life. There is a method to my madness. So just kind of showing everything and how I put them. But thank you so much for joining me. And yeah, just go out there, be creative, and just find some different things and share with me some of your ideas. I love learning from other people and just how they place things and where they put them and just their different ideas, and just kind of being a little bit more unconventional when it comes to putting things together. So if you like these type of videos, go ahead and hit the like button and subscribe for more. I love doing just makeup tutorials, reviews, DIYs is like my favorite, and things for the home and just putting all that decor all together. I love all things art. So whether it's home decor, you know, fashion, makeup, all things, I just love putting those ideas together. So I will join you in my next video for the next thing I decide to do next. Thank you. Bye.
So this is the back patio. This is that whole kind of like sea nautical thing that I was going for. And I wanted to kind of stay in the same kind of color range. And so as you can see, I ended up just going with, ta-da, the whale. I thought it was fun. I thought it went with the theme and it fit the hose because we have like one of those kind of like retractable type hoses in the back. And once the water's all out, it fit perfectly once you intertwine it inside. So I wanted to think just something different that was gonna be something a little bit more unexpected and cute and outside the box, and it worked perfectly. It went with the theme, and I adore it. I think it's so cute. And then with that same starfish jar, I had these red coral pieces that I bought from Pottery Barn years ago, and I still had them around, and so I ended up just like putting those inside and then putting the candle around it so that it can kind of tie in the red from the other cushions that I had in the back patio. But just with the pop of color on the inside, it really highlighted the gold on the outside, and I figured that worked out perfectly, so I'm really happy with that purchase. So it's just gonna, you know, a fun addition to the backyard, just kind of tying in the red from the cushions and different things that I have going out there. So as you can see, I'm always adding to the back patio. I'm really glad that this whale and just all the other items that I picked out worked out so well. It's just so cute, and it kind of goes with that whole nautical theme, and I'm very excited about it. I think he's so cute. But it's still a work in progress. So if you guys have any comments as to what I should add, take away, I know I'm still kind of working on changing some of these lanterns. I think I need something a little bit taller, but I'm really happy with how everything turned out so far. And this rug was beautiful. I actually ended up getting this from wayfair.com, and yeah, it's not necessarily a outside or outdoor rug, but with the low pile, I figured, you know, it's really great, it's durable, and it's been keeping up in the weather, so it's been really, really nice. So sometimes, even though it says it's for this, try using it for something totally different. So I'm kind of still working on this area and seeing, not quite sure, what should I add, what should I take away? Again, leave me your comments, but thank you so much for watching, and don't forget to subscribe.